Hello students, today we are going to discuss about female reproductive system part 2. In previous lecture we have discussed already about female reproductive system, in which we have already discussed about paired ovaries, okay, and we have already learned about accessory duct, in which we have discussed about oviduct, fallopian tube, uterus and vagina. And in today's lecture, we are going to discuss about external genitalia, in which we will discuss about mons pubis, vestibule, hymen and clitoris. So let me discuss about external genitalia. Okay, so external genitalia may also called as a vulva. Okay, and it is also called as a pudendum. Okay, so these two other names are synonyms of external genitalia, that is a vulva and pudendum. Okay, and it will consist of mons pubis. Here you can see in this diagram, this is the region that is called mons pubis. Okay, then vestibule, this region, this opening is called vestibule region. Okay, then hymen, as I already told you in previous lecture, what is a hymen? And finally, there is a structure, very sensitive structure, that is called clitoris. Here you can see the structure. Okay, that will be resemble a male penis. Okay, so that is called clitoris. Okay, so let me discuss one by one. What is a mons pubis? So mons pubis, here you can see, okay, that is a cushion of a fatty tissue. It will be look like a cushion of a fatty tissue and it will be covered by pubic hair. Okay, here you can see it will be covered with the pubic hair. So that is called mons pubis. Next structure is a vestibule. So this whole structure, this whole opening, okay, and that is called vestibule. And that is a median channel. It include labia majora and labia minora. Okay, so here you can see, okay, this is the labia minora inner side, that is a small labia, okay, and this is a larger one. So that is called labia majora. Larger one is called labia majora and smaller one is called labia minora. So labia majora is a large, fleshy, fatty and hairy outer fold. Okay, and it will be surrounding the vaginal opening. Here you can see the vaginal opening and surrounding that there will be labia majora. You can see here. Okay, and then next one is a labia minora. That is a small, thin and hairless. This will be hairless structure and that is a hairless inner fold. Okay, so here you can see all the structure which will be included into the vulva or pudendum, that is called external genitalia, which include mons pubis, clitoris, urethral opening here, okay, then labia majora, labia minora, then vagina, and finally this is the anus, that is the digestive tract opening. Now let me discuss in detail about vestibule. The vestibule is a space with a two aperture. Okay, so it having a two aperture. One is a upper urethral orifice. Okay, that is the opening of a urethra or urinary tract. Okay, that is called urethral orifice and lower vaginal orifice. So two opening will be there inside the vestibule. One is a urethral opening and second one is a vaginal opening. Okay, so upper urethral orifice and then lower vaginal orifice will be found. Here you can see. Okay, this one is the vaginal opening. Okay, and this is the urethral opening. Now the vestibule is bound by two pair of a fleshy fold of tissues. Okay, it will be bound with the two pair of a fleshy fold. One will be smaller and one will be larger. Okay, so smaller one is called labia minora. Smaller fold is called labia minora. And larger fold, that is the outer side, is called labia majora. Here you can see labia minora first and then labia majora. Next structure is a hymen, that is also called maiden head, and which we have already discussed in previous lecture. Okay, so it is a membrane which is partially cover the vaginal opening and it is often torn during the first coitus. Okay, it will be torn during the first coitus, during first sexual intercourse, and that's why it will be symbolized as a, in some culture there will be symbol of a virginity. Okay, so hymen may also be break. That is a myth. Okay, this is the myth that often torn during the first coitus. It is not so. Okay, it will not so that only during the first coitus it will be break. Sometime what happen, hymen may also broken by sudden fall of a jolt. Okay, or insertion of a vaginal tampon. okay, which is used during the menstrual cycle, and active participation in some sports even, okay, and in some women hymen persists even after coitus. Sometime what happen, even after coitus or the sexual intercourse, it will be remain persist. Okay, so the hymen is not a reliable indicator of virginity. Okay, scientifically we cannot say that hymen is a reliable indicator of virginity. Okay, so hymen is not the reliable indicator of virginity, we can say that. Okay, next is a clitoris. Here you can see, okay, that is a clitoris, and it will be very, we can say clearly, we can say this is the structure which will be similar to the male penis. Okay, it is a highly sensitive organ. This organ is a highly sensitive, lying just in front of a urethral opening. Suppose this is the urethral opening here. Okay, this is very small opening, that's why you cannot even observe this. Okay, this is a small opening, just above that it will be lying. Okay, so it is a highly sensitive organ lying just in front of a urethral opening. So let me discuss about clitoris in detail. So it is a sensitive erectile structure. As I told you already, penis is also erectile structure. During coitus or sexual intercourse, it will be erect just due to muscle erections. Okay, so it is also just like a penis in the male, clitoris also erectile structure. So it will erect during the sexual intercourse. It lies at the upper junction of the two labia minora above the urethral orifice. That is the exact position of this clitoris. It is homologous to penis of a male, and as both are supported by corpora cavernosa. As I told you already, if we have already studied the penis structure, okay, cross section of a penis, and we have already observed that inside the penis there is a tissue that is called corpora cavernosa. So here also, in case of a clitoris also, there is a presence of a corpora cavernosa internally. Okay, and Mons pubis is a cushion of a fatty tissue. Already I told you what is a Mons pubis. Mons pubis is a cushion of a fatty tissue covered by skin and pubic hair present above the labia majora. So this is the clitoris here. And next topic is a female accessory reproductive gland. So in the female accessory reproductive gland, you can see here total three glands are there. First is a Bartholin's gland, or it is also called greater vestibular gland. Okay, and second is a Skene's gland, and it is also called lesser vestibular gland. Okay, and third one is a mammary gland, which is also called milk secreting gland. So let me discuss one by one. First of all, let me discuss about Bartholin's gland, that is also called greater vestibular gland. Okay, these are pair gland. Okay, this is present in the pair. They are located slightly posterior and to the left and right side of the vaginal orifice. So exactly where it is located slightly posterior and to the left and right sides of the vaginal orifice. They secrete mucus to lubricate the vagina. Their main purpose of the this Bartholin gland is to secrete mucus and to lubricate the vagina. Okay, and they are homologous to, exactly it will be homologous to bulbourethral gland present in the male. So this will resemble the Bartholin gland, which is have same function as per the bulbourethral gland in the male. Okay, and they are homologous to bulbourethral gland of a male of a reproductive system. Next gland is a Skene's gland, and that is also called lesser vestibular gland. Okay, they are located on the anterior wall of the vagina. Okay, that was a posterior end. Okay, Bartholin gland was at a posterior end. Okay, and here they are located on the anterior wall of the vagina around the lower end of the urethra. Okay, and they secrete a lubricating fluid when it will be stimulated during the sexual intercourse. They are homologous to the prostate gland of a male. So this is also having homology with the prostate gland of a male. So exactly they will have same function as the prostate gland found in the male. Next important gland is a mammary gland or a breast. Okay, and it is also called a milk secreting gland. Okay, and a pair of a mammary gland contain glandular tissue and fats. Okay, here you can see this is a glandular tissues, and also surrounding that this yellowish color is a pectoral fat pads. Okay, a pair of a mammary gland contain glandular tissue and a fat. Glandular tissue of each breast has 15 to 20 mammary lobes. Okay, here you can see this is a mammary lobes. Okay, and number of that is 15 to 20. it will containing cluster of a cell, and that is called mammary alveoli. Okay, the specific kind of a cells which is present here is a mammary alveoli, and that is called cluster of a cells. Okay, the cells of a alveoli secrete milk. Okay, that cluster of a cell will secrete the milk. It is stored in the cavities, or it is also called lumen. Okay, and the lumen of the alveoli. So inside this, you can see here, this is the cluster of cells together, and it will form the alveoli, inside which one cavity will be there, and that is called lumen, and the inside which a milk will be secreted and stored. So here in this diagram, you can clearly observe this portion is a nipple. Okay, surrounding that, there is a pigmented tissue. Okay, and that is called areola. Okay, then this is the lactiferous sinus here. This one is a lactiferous sinus, or it is called mammary ampulla. Okay, then lactiferous duct here. Okay, and then finally you can see the lobules of two lobes, lobes of the mammary glands. So many lobules are there. Then there is a suspensory ligament here, which will hold the breast. Okay, then pectoral fat surrounding them. Then pectoralis majoris muscle. This is very important. This pectoralis major muscle play very important role for holding the breast tissue. Okay, and this is a mammary duct here. Okay, then mammary tubules here. This is the mammary tubules. And finally, whatever the balloon-like structure or bag-like or sac-like structure is a mammary alveoli. And the alveoli opens into mammary tubules. Okay, this alveoli here you can see it will open in the mammary tubules. These are the tubules. Okay, so this is a cluster of a mammary alveoli here you can see, and that will open inside this tubule. Okay, and this will produce the milk. Okay, and then now milk will be secreted inside this tubule. The tubules of each lobe join to form a mammary duct. Okay, so it will join together, all tubules join together and form mammary duct. So first of all, alveoli is there. Then it will open into the mammary tubule. Then all tubule together form mammary duct. Okay, and this all duct, several mammary duct here will join to form a wider mammary ampulla. Okay, so this portion, this wider portion of a duct is called mammary ampulla. Okay, and which is connected to the lactiferous tubule or a duct. Okay, here you can see this is connected with the lactiferous duct, and through which milk will be sucked out by the fetus or a child. So all of you notice the sequence of a milk conduction. So what is the sequence of milk conduction? So first of all, it will be secreted into the mammary alveoli. Okay, and inside that it will be stored. Okay, and then this milk will be transferred to the mammary tubule. Then it will be passed to the mammary duct, and finally it will reach up to the mammary ampulla, and finally it will reach up to the lactiferous duct. Up to this, whatever we have discussed is all about male and female reproductive organs. Okay, now let me discuss about, and we can compare in between male and female externally and internally. Okay, so first of all, here you can see the list of character, and we will discuss with the comparison with the male and female. Okay, so first of all, here you can see a general built up. Okay, so body of male and female is a male body is more muscular than the female body. Okay, then aggressiveness, the nature of a male is more aggressive than the female. Okay, and if you observe hair growth, then on the facial hair you can see or observe beard or mustache in a male, whereas in female it is totally absent. Second, hair growth you will observe in the underarm, that is axillary hair growth, and that is present in the male and even in the female. That is a similarity. Okay, pubic hair distribution more lateral and upward towards the umbilicus. Okay, and here upper growth not so marked, and it more horizontal in case of a female. Here it will be upward umbilicus, and here it is horizontal. Okay, then on the chest, here in case of a male, on the chest hair growth will be present. Heavy in case of a female, it will be totally absent. Mammary gland, in case of a male, there is a presence, but it is underdeveloped. Okay, or undeveloped. Here in case of a female, it is well developed. Fifth character is a skin. Okay, so if you observe male skin, then it will be hairy and coarse. Okay, whereas in female, you will observe hairy and soft skin. If you observe shoulder, then here shoulder will be more broad than the female. Seventh character is a pelvis. Okay, so here in case of male, pelvis is not broad, whereas in female, pelvis is more broad because they have to carry the pregnancy. Okay, and 8-1 is a larynx. Here more apparent, here less apparent. Okay, then voice will be here a low pitch voice in case of male, and in the female it will be high pitch voice. Okay, and if you observe BMR, okay, that is a high due to greater activity. Male do very high activity, and let's say here BMR is higher than the female, not so high as compared to males. So this is your homework for today's lecture, and before we finish this lecture, let me summarize all topic by using one animation video. So look at this video.
Male external genitalia includes the mons pubis, labia majora, labia minora, and the clitoris. The labia majora consists of fleshy folds of tissue that extends down from the mons pubis and surrounds the vaginal opening. Hidden under the labia majora is the labia minora. Towards its upper end lies the clitoris, a small finger-like structure, and below it is the urethral opening. The female reproductive system is supported by the mammary glands. The mammary glands or breasts are modified sweat glands that lie over the pectoral muscles. They contain glandular tissues and a variable amount of fat. Internally, each breast is divided into 15 to 20 mammary lobes containing clusters of cells called the alveoli. The alveoli open into the mammary tubules. The tubules of each lobe join to form the mammary duct. Several ducts join to form a wider ampulla, which is connected to the lactiferous duct. The lactiferous duct opens out through the nipple from which milk is sucked out.
In next lecture, we will learn about gametogenesis, and in which we will discuss about spermatogenesis. So till that, goodbye.